Hi, I am Valder Beebe. I am the host and the visionary of That Celebrity Interview.
Dr. Tanya Altman, thank you so much for joining me here live in Dallas, Texas on the Valder Beebe Show as I broadcast live across America on FM. How are you today?
I'm fine. Thank you for having me on.
Thank you, because you've got an important topic. You're here to help us with the healthy routine for our child. You're a pediatrician, your mom. We think you know a lot.
Well, thank you. I do talk to families in my office every day, and sleep is one of the most important things we talk about this time of year, which is why I'm excited to partner with Natrol on this Child Healthy Sleep campaign.
Okay, so give us some tips for getting our kids into a healthy bedtime routine, especially when we're going from summer to school time.
So during the summer, kids often stay up later running around the neighborhood or maybe playing too many video games. And now that school's either already started or about to start, you got to get that bedtime a little bit earlier. So I usually suggest moving it 15 minutes earlier every few nights until you hit that correct bedtime where your kids are getting 10 hours of sleep at night. That's right. They do need 10 hours of sleep in order to focus and concentrate and learn at school. So how do you do it? Well, make sure they get plenty of exercise during the day. An hour before bedtime, turn all those electronics and screens off, get them out of your kid's bedroom, and then start your relaxing, calm bedtime routine, which might include a shower bath, brushing teeth, reading your younger children a story, or having your older ones read quietly in their bed, hugs and kisses, and then lights out.
Okay, you talk about those of us who have a bedtime hour, but some parents, I go to their house, kids are up later than them. What should we have for them? They don't have a bedtime.
Definitely. Well, you do need a bedtime. And so I usually ask parents, what time do your kids have to get up in the morning for school? Then we go backwards 10 hours, and that's when they have to go to sleep at night. An hour before that, bedtime routine starts, period. And you have to let your kids know, give them a warning. We're going to start bedtime routine in 2 minutes, in 5 minutes, and then do your relaxing bedtime routine that's consistent every night. And parents need to role model the same thing. Now, sometimes you do have families that are having a little trouble, especially this time of year. And that's often when I recommend giving kids a dose of melatonin. I like Natrol Kids Melatonin. It's low dose, 1 milligram. It tastes really good, and it's a safe, effective way to help get your kids back on track so they get enough sleep this school year.
How does melatonin work?
So melatonin is naturally produced by the brain when the sun goes down and it's dark at night. And that's what signals your body it's time to go to sleep, and it controls our sleep-wake cycle. And then when the sun comes up in the morning, that's when the brain stops producing melatonin.
Okay. I'm going to try some of those with my kids, and we're going to see. I think that might work for them. Where can we go for more information?
For more information on healthy sleep tips and melatonin, visit natrol.com.
All right, I'm going to stop my kids from ruling the house, Dr. Tanya. Thank you so much.
You can do it. Get a good night's sleep.
Thank you, Dr. Tanya. Bye-bye.
Hi, I'm Valder Beebe. I host the Valder Beebe Show, broadcast on radio and television. And this is My Phone Pouch. My phone pouch is a great invention. It allows me to go hands-free, pocket-free, purse-free, even belt-free. Head on over to myphonepouch.com.